never let it be said that Oakland does not know how to rock. Oh my gosh, this is why I went through the election process, is just to do this. Of being the mayor of the amazing city of Oakland is that you get to proclaim days. Gentlemen, did you ever think that this would be your official day? Well, it is. So this is an official City of Oakland Mayor's Proclamation. I'm going to get a little help reading it. Whereas Green Day was formed in the East Bay in 1987. This is beautiful, you gotta listen to this, people. Based on a common understanding that music is the most powerful force to inspire fun and hope in the world, a sentiment the band carries with them to this day with their soaring anthems, sharp humor, and heartfelt lyrical honesty. And generations, from their multi-platinum Grammy Award-winning album Dookie that created a tidal wave of inspiration for the disaffected around the world, to their equally heralded album American Idiot and its honest critique of a political landscape gone awry, and
whereas
Green Day's nearly 30 years of creative adventures have placed them firmly in the family of legendary East Bay bands who continue to inspire on the world stage, a reputation that garnered them first ballot introduction into the 2015 Rock and Roll. Including, but not limited to, Christy Road, Welcome to Paradise, Basket Case, Good Riddance, Time of Your Life, Minority, Boulevard of Broken Dreams, and 21 Guns. Lift the most downtrodden spirits and open the most closed minds, and don't worry, it's coming. Whereas Green Day continues to cultivate a connection to their local community through their participation in benefits for Children's Hospital of Oakland. And their pride in keeping their business local through independent ventures, such as, are you ready, Mike? Oakland Coffee. Jingle Town Recording. Rudy's Can't Fail Cafe. Atomic Garden and Broken Guitar. And whereas the legend of Green Day is being celebrated this day as a tribute concert featuring band members Billy Joe Armstrong, Mike Dirnt, and Trey Cool. Plus, 14 local Bay Area bands organized by Undercover Presents. Nine 24 Gilman. Where even the mayor of Oakland has to admit that she is partied from time to time. And Fantasy Studios. At Oakland's landmark Fox Theater. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that Friday, February 19th, 2016 is, in the city of Oakland, Green Day Day.
This is hella cool. Thanks a lot, everybody, from Undercover. What an amazing night of these songs that everybody just made their own and did their own thing to it. And totally original, some really original. And it was great. It's like a beautiful feeling and totally awkward at the same time. It's like, I don't know if I was late to my funeral or early to it. I couldn't tell. No, sorry. But it was great. Thanks a lot, Kamala. Thank you, Libby. Kamala was the first person to shave my head, by the way. And get that long gross hair off. I know. I think of all the streets, like if I think of like Telegraph Avenue, and I think of Shattuck and MLK. But the one avenue that always sticks out in my mind is like when I was thinking it, it's the artery that goes all the way from the sticks where we're from, where there's Port Costa, Crockett, and Romeo. But San Pablo Avenue was the one street that connected us, where I moved all the way out to West Oakland when I was 18 years old, and I got a chance to try to find something else that we can get into. It's like the song Welcome to Paradise is about that experience. And I don't know, San Pablo Avenue, you go, all of a sudden you're on Gilman Street, you know? And it's like, you're right there. And you think of everything in between, like you think about El Cerrito, and it's like, that's where the Vagrants is from. And then you're in Albany, and that's where Operation Ivy Lance is from. And then, you're in Berkeley, and that's where Grimshine is from, you know? You get to Oakland, and it's like you get Neurosis, you get Christ on Parade. And when I wrote the breakdown, I remember the breakdown for Welcome to Paradise, I wanted to be like Neurosis. Because they were the kings of the East Bay punk scene back then. But so thanks a lot, David. Anyways, I don't know, Gilman's a really special place. And the one thing that we really have to keep doing is the next generation of people to keep playing music and to encourage young people to keep playing music and to stay off the computer unless they're making music on the computer. But there are no rules. There's no rules. It doesn't have to be. You can do it on a cassette tape. You can record it onto a computer. You can record it to your phone. Just make music and express yourself. And be original, like all the people that are up here tonight. And that's something I value very much inside me, because I think that, you know, Green Day, we are an East Bay band. And it's important, you don't want to see any of these punk houses getting closed down because of gentrification or anything like that. You want to make sure that our music community is, they're not moving to other places, that we keep them here, we keep them home, here in Oakland, in Berkeley. So, with that said, I'm not going anywhere, I'm staying here. You know, everybody, sometimes every once in a while, after Dookie came out, people are like, well, why didn't you move to Los Angeles? I was like, no, I mean, they have their moments, which is good. I don't know. I got nothing against Los Angeles, not personally. Like, it's great, you know? The beach, hey, it's cool. But I love being here. I've raised my kids here. This is where I was raised. My father's from Berkeley. My whole family is from the East Bay. Sometimes via Oklahoma, but that's, you know, a whole different story. Anyways, it's really special making this record. We did it at Fantasy Studios in 1993. And, you know, we took a big risk at the time. And in the community, it was a little sketchy, you know? But I think, remember this, like after our last show at Gilman Street, I was like, This is okay. This will be the last time that we play here. It was in around 1993. And I feel like it gave way for the next generation to come in and do something on an independent level. And that's the great thing about Gilman Street, is like you come in, you play your gig, you clean the toilet, you take out the garbage, you help do security, and you try to figure out who you are in a bunch of teenage socialist environment. So, anyways, thanks a lot, Gilman, for everything. This one's for you. Thanks a lot, everybody, Undercover. Thank you, Libby. This is great. Thanks to you. And we're gonna make more music. So. Oh, wait. We're gonna announce in the next band. Want me to do it? Hey guys, the next band that's going to play for you right now, some dear friends of mine, we go way back. We go at least two blocks away back. So anyways, what's the name of your band? This band is called Skank Bank.
I've gone there and volunteered for like most shows in the past 3 years.
It's really a communal place, and you know, everyone knows each other and everyone bonds over music and has a great sense of community there.
Green Day. I don't know how old I was, but I think it was Welcome to Paradise. It was the first one I heard. I didn't know what genre it was, what it was. I knew it was sick. I knew I wanted to hear all the music, and they were my favorite band. They were most influential in my playing. Still, I think so. You know, Trey Cool, fantastic drummer. That's really what got me started. I'd say American Idiot, probably the first time I heard the word fuck so many times in a row. Definitely changed the way I talked forever.
Well, Common Clean, I think, was a really perfect song choice for us. 17 kind of plays the first time. First one.
The problem with that, just don't understand.
Wow, that's so sad. It's so, I hate to admit it, but like, they just know. We're Skank Bank. The this song's Coming Clean.
Down there, check it out. Lavender. Ooh, yeah.
Hey, guys. We are totally honored to be here. Thank you so much for coming out. This is Coming Clean. We'll be right back.
We're a collective of about 1,500 musicians here in Oakland, people who love orchestral music, but we want to make orchestras more accessible to people. We seek out adventures in the way that we play, and with whom we play, where we play, and what kind of music we play. And that's why we play music, to have a good time with each other and share something with another person. And music is a really powerful conduit for that. So I think my first experience with Green Day's music was when I was 12 years old in 1994, and Dookie came out, and my older sister, from whom I received all things musical, brought home their cassette tape one day of the album, and we listened to it just every day, driving to school back and forth, and I've been a fan ever since. I kind of let Brian take the lead on this, with choosing this, and I mean, it's like this is the only song written by Mike Dirnt, the bass player from Green Day. And Brian did this awesome, trippy, lush dreamscape of arrangement for us. And I just kind of helped rally the troops as the conductor. And that's the most fun thing about working with an orchestra. You're always collaborating with hundreds of people. Trying to wrap my head around the fact that I'm going to be paying tribute to this awesome band and this awesome album and recording a tribute to it in the room that it was recorded in. I just, not only is that mind-blowing, but thinking about, okay, well, what's next then? What's the next project going to be like? What other piece of music or inspiration in my life is going to come back in some way? It's, you know, the sky's the limit. And that's what these projects and being involved in Undercover, that's why they get me so excited.
Casey Crescenzo couldn't make it tonight, but we have Oakland's own Sam Schwartz, our running back. Just a great vocal, give it up for Sam, and awesome on the say that whenever you hear an orchestra or a band that sounds awesome, there's a brilliant arranger behind that song. And we are very lucky because our arranger for that song that you just heard and that you're going to hear was your very own guest music director tonight, Brian Adam McHugh. Give it up. Give it up for Brian, our guest music director. He's been my best friend for 15 years, and he helped me run this orchestra and helped us when we did Stand last year, and it's just a huge honor to share the stage with him. So, give it up for Brian.
For those of you who weren't here last year at the Fox, David Mesher was the guest music director for Sly and the Family Stone Stand, the one who just gave your intro right there. Can we give it up for her? Are you here at the Sly and the Family Stone Stand show? A huge thank you for the Fox for taking a chance on local musicians taking the stage. So there are a lot of you who are new to the concept of Undercover. For those of you who don't know, we have a guest music director for every album to which we pay tribute to. And when we look for a guest music director, we look for someone who has a lot of qualities. Number one, you have your shit together. You're not another stereotype of a flake musician, but you're the stereotype of someone who takes shit seriously because you love what you do and you respect everyone you work with. For Undercover, we look for musicians that are a hub. We look for musicians that are not stifled into the box of one genre, that you really challenge yourself. You like to play with different genres, you like to play with different arrangements, you like to play with different band configurations. And we look for just good people. We look for people who have their finger on their pulse, who know what good music sounds like. Even if it's an awesome band that draws three people to their show, you know it's a fucking awesome band. And that's what Undercover is all about. We put the spotlight on local bands, and we don't care where your draw is. We love what you do as a musician, and we get to play at crazy awesome venues like the Fox. And thank you for taking a chance on us for supporting tonight.
Inside the showing. First of all, thank you all for being here tonight. You know, this is nothing without an audience, so give yourselves a round of applause. This is like the third Undercover I've been a part of. I was lucky to be to play on Radiohead's Kid A tribute, and yeah, that was a great show. I was just asked to be like an extra hand with Bell's Atlas, another Oakland band. And then Dave, my best friend who you just met, was the guest music director for Sly and the Family Stone Stand, and that was all wonderful, and he got to ask me to arrange for the opening track. And I came to the Paul Simon's Graceland show, and Lyz had a bag for me under my chair, and I just said future guest music director, and I was totally floored. I didn't think I would get this honor, and I take it very, very seriously. And when she stood up in front of everyone, she said, "Hey Brian, do you want to do Bjork?" And I love Bjork, don't get me wrong. But I was right next to my good friend Geneva, who is also a future guest music director, who will be doing Bjork. And I thought about it, and I was like, I really want to do Green Day's Dookie. And Lyz said, you realize that's 14 tracks. That means 14 bands. That means you're going to have to work really, really hard. And I said, I'm up for it, because I wanted to pay tribute to this album. There was this wonderful opportunity to make this as a tie-in to benefit 94 Gilman. And we are lucky to feature four 94 Gilman bands tonight. You haven't seen the last one yet. And I do know that you are all here to not hear me talk, but to hear music. So I'm going to hand it over to a very new friend of mine and an extremely talented artist, Martin Luther, for In the End.
My name is Martin Luther McCoy from San Francisco, California. I play rebel soul music. In general, you know, I do soul music in a classic form, but I have a penchant for the rock and roll. I get Green Day props because, now here's a real interesting story. I was doing like a VH1 taping in LA, and they were like the feature talent performer. But in between doing their hit songs, they're playing like jazz music, like some Frank Sinatra or something. And it was the coolest thing, so I'm expecting to see the rock dudes, you know, just out there ready to wail. But in between time, they're just grooving on some straight-ahead jazz. I was like, yeah, respect to the musicianship. The thing about the process has been actually working in bouncy studios, being in these rooms, and just learning about the history and the other people that have walked in these halls and recorded on these microphones. It's inspiring. The collaborative process for this Undercover SF project is pretty fantastic because you have musicians lending themselves and their ideas and their creativity to assist, sometimes without even asked, in order to make a project or a song better. And that's kind of rare, you know, just because there's a certain unselfishness. I wanted to make Indian upbeat rock tune, and I've been driving the truck the whole way. We could start it off loud and noisy with some fuzz distortion and some overdrive, feedback, and then came in with a monster groove. But my producer and partner, Paisley, he fought me on it. But it was like, they're already a rock band, so why make a rock sound interpretation? And we ended up creating something with Brian McCoon's assistance that has now stages of development in one song. And then I created a bridge that didn't exist. And we made something that we're quite proud of. And we're going to be helped out with the awesome orchestra on stage to my dancing arrangements that I have. And now it's up to you. We've done our part in the studio. It's time to get busy. Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy In the End by Martin. Thank you.
We had no idea what to expect. When we went on tour, Green Day hadn't really slid into the whole major label persona, so to speak, yet, so they were still touring in a bookmobile, a repurposed bookmobile. But they could have taken any other band. They could have listened to their management and let other bands actually pay to go off on tour with them, but they took Pansy Division, which was a local queer-friendly band in the Bay Area, to open for them, and they took Tilt to support them for that whole 7-week tour. So they really felt an affinity for their community and gave back. Well, you know, the other bands on this tribute are not necessarily from the Gilman scene, per se, and their style isn't pop punk. And I think that's wonderful because I think Dookie stands the test of being able to be filtered through the psyche of all these different artists and something completely original come out. However, with FOD, I wasn't trying to emulate Billy or anything, but we did come out of the same scene, so I think we have some of the same aesthetic. And when we were laying down the track, the orchestra that I could hear through the headphones was really giving me the energy and the lift that I needed to bring that vocal track. Thanks for coming, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed all the other artists who have contributed to this project. And now check out Cinder Block, Bill Collins, Pete Griffith, and Awesome Orchestra with F.O.D. If you don't know what that means, fuck off and die.
melody.
We have spent over a year working on the show. I hope you enjoyed it tonight. So, for those of you who haven't been to an Undercover show, have a little tradition. I ask y'all to raise your right hand. We're about to take a pledge of support. A pledge of support in local music. Will y'all please repeat after me? I state your name.
I state your name.
How many of you said state your name?
I state your name.
Solemnly swear.
Solemnly swear.
Here at the Fox Theater.
Here at the Fox Theater.
On Friday, February 19th.
Thanks a lot, everybody. Oh my god, thank you guys. That was, I don't know. You guys were fantastic. It was just incredible. Thanks a lot.
Big round of applause for El Duque.
When Mike first played the bass line to Long View to me and he was on LSD, I think this is what he was imagining right now. Anyways, I got nothing.
You know you're in the place to be because Steve the Lyz is here.